time to come into
further.
It.
Further.
Oh, no, go, okay, now go back two shots.
Go back two shots.
I think it's important for everyone to be able to participate in the creation of their media. And by providing tools that are powerful but simple, it becomes possible to do that. MPS is the first step in that direction.
There.
I love this thing.
And now see this overlap here?
Mm-hmm.
What this is saying is that these two objects overlap like this. So this is a transition. It can be a dissolve or a wipe or whatever kind of transition you want. Okay.
This is hot.
Okay, so now you've built
this
that.
This one could do it.
That
okay,
one
wonderful.
That one fits. Now,
one of the key and most important characteristics of MPS is the application of the Macintosh interface to multimedia composition or to video editing. That is the ability that you have in the desktop or in a lot of Macintosh applications to interact directly with the content rather than the medium. You're not typing in commands, you're clicking on a segment of film and moving it to another place in your segment. And that's exactly what you want to do. You don't want to have to deal with the medium. You don't want to have to type in frame numbers. You want to work directly with your ideas as they're portrayed on the screen.
The major thing the Macintosh gives us is that people already have a good idea of what it does and how to use it. And the editing task in MPS is essentially making a picture of what the program is supposed to look like. And you do that by making boxes, and the longer a box is, the more time it takes. And the sorts of graphic manipulations that you do on that, dragging things, moving things, pulling things, are all common to the Macintosh. So our expectation is that in a commercial version of this system, anyone with, say, an hour's training would know what to do. And that the hard part is now not manipulating the system, but having a picture in your head of what the result's supposed to be. The first stage is collecting your material, and to do that the system has an area called a workspace, which is modeled on the light table. It is in that place that you can create objects or have objects created from a database and start working with them graphically. You can start shoving them around, putting them in piles, putting them in collections, getting a rough idea of how you want the thing to work.
There are three kinds of objects: a moving object, a still object, and a sound object. I create those objects by pulling one of these icons from the top here into the workspace, and then I can just cruise the disk, find something that I'm interested in, like this guy. Yeah, I like him. So I found the image that I want to take, and I tell it to make an icon. Guy with fish. And now when I click on this object, brings up the guy with the fish.
The next step is to sequence those things in time. And for that, we have a time editor. And you drag objects from the workspace into the time editor. And in the time editor, you do the synchronization. The synchronization is an iterative process. You move a couple objects onto it, put a soundtrack on it, put some narration on it, play it. If you want to insert something, you can slice an object in half and pull it apart and put new things in between them. It's very flexible.
Let's do it again.
Well, sure, the Spanish have been there for centuries.
Like, let's say I wanted it to hit hard on Spanish, but just pull it to come up later, like I did right here.
Well, sure, the Spanish have been there for centuries.
And if I wanted to tweak it, let's say I wanted it to really hit hard.
Sure, the Spanish have been there for...
I can perform it in real time just by punching on the space bar where I want that edit to happen. So what that does is put a mark up on this track. And you can see that mark right here. And then I'll tell it to align to that mark. And now when we play the edit...
Well, sure, the Spanish have been there for
perfect.
Centuries.
So it's very, very easy to get things just where you want. It's just as easy to work with sound as it is to work with pictures. I have this split into two tracks. The bottom track plays the music, the top track plays the voice. So I'm able to work with both elements independently. So by simply moving these blocks on these tracks, you're able to change where the events occur in time. Very simple way of working.
When you're first collecting material before you get to MPS, it's important usually to log everything that you're doing so you know exactly what you're working with. And it's a good idea to computerize that log for all of the obvious reasons. MPS can take your computerized log and synthesize all the objects that it needs automatically. So you come into the segment with your workspace already filled with everything that you're going to need.
Because I'm working with so many images, the MPS makes it easy for me to not only find the things that I want with the digital light table, but also organize them and put them together in a fast, flexible way. I could not do the segments that I do the way that I'm doing them with traditional video tools.
It remembers the entire state of every segment, so it knows what all of the objects are in time and where they came from. It also remembers everything in the workspace and everything that you've been playing with, so it knows all your material. It can even keep track of several versions of the same segment so that you could like have an editor's version and a producer's version.
I put things together in time, and then if I want to make a change, I just make the change at the place that I want to make the change, and everything else is taken care of. I'm able to make changes without having to worry about relaying the whole show. So. You're able to take risks that you normally would not want to take.
Given the tradition of literacy in this country, it was important that everyone learn how to read, and that's been very important. We haven't done the same thing in video. Everyone knows how to watch it, but people don't really understand what it does. It's the single most important communication medium in this country. And most television viewers have no idea of the real limitations of the medium and its inherent biases. And I think if people become video literate, which the system can enable them to be, then they will have much more control over the power of television.
Although it may come into the home under the guise of an editing system, what people will begin to realize is that it's a process of discovery that they're undergoing. It's a creation process. They're understanding what they wanted to say, as they compose it with the multimedia objects.
And it's simple enough that you can give it to teachers, you can give it to kids, you can give it to anyone, and turn them into media creators. It's a very, very powerful thing. I think it's important as we find new ways to communicate.